we are going to cover today. So yes, Vivek and Harsha, over to you.
Yes, thank you, Maharshi sir. So good morning, all of you. This is Vivek from IOS team. First of all, thank you for joining this session. So let me give you the brief of the current session. In the last session, Harsha and team has covered some of the topics in the detail, like how we can create the project, how we can create the board, what are the types of boards, what is epic story, how we can create story, how we can create sprint. So today again, we will revise some of the things so that we can clear whatever misconception we have. First of all, I want to thank Maharshi sir that you have cleared one thing here, that Kanban and Scrum is not like that. Kanban we can use only for the QA purpose, right? Some of us, or so many from us, has misconception that Kanban can be only with the QA. This is not like that. So we will go through these things in the detail, and then we will ask Rizwan sir to cover advanced topic like what is story point, what is story weightage. Okay. So I am sharing my screen. Sir, can you allow me to share the screen?
Yes, you should be able to do that now.
Yes. Can everyone see my screen?
Yeah. Yes, we can see.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So guys, that if you guys wanted to learn this, for planning and plotting the task and everything, then you have a next generation project where Jira guys have made simplified things for us, right? And if you want to go into detail for planning, plotting, task, everything, then we have classic project where we have two types of board, Scrum board and Kanban board, right? So whenever you want to create anything with a proper planning, when you want to deliver the things to the client in the sprint wise, or you want to take a in out of the delay of the project, then you can go with the Scrum board. And whenever you have you don't want to plan in that much of detail, your project is not that much of big, and you have not delivered to task to the client in a sprint, then you can select Kanban board for your purpose. So here it is not like that Kanban can be used only for the QA. This is Jira is a process which can be varied to the organization to organization, team to team, right? So in Brainwire, we have selected that Kanban we will use mostly for the QA purpose. Okay. So let's create classic project which contains Scrum and Kanban board. So when you first create a project, it will ask for the name. Let's say mobile demo project. Then you have two options to change the templates: Kanban, Scrum, or bug tracking. So you can select whatever it fits to your requirement. So today we will look at the SCUM. So now it has created a project for us. So you can check here a backlog, active sprint, MDP board, mobile demo, project board. So you can create also another board by tapping create board, where you can again select you want to create a Scrum board or Kanban board. So mostly this can be used, let's say in a mobile application, we have a front team and API team, right? So you can the backend team, right? So Rizwan sir and other expert, I also like to request you to guide in between if I am doing something wrong or the things which we can do in the better way.
There is one correction in your basic concept like Kanban board and the Scrum board. I think Scrum board should be used. Complex projects like we don't know what will come next on our board or the things or the task is not certainly defined. We have the few sets of tasks that we can start work on them, and after that there might be some. Scrum board where we have backlog items that. Backlog item will change definitely time to time by the client input, by our team's input, or by a PM's input, and we will go with the Kanban board when we have all the tasks. Is the difference between Kanban and Scrum board?
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
So now when you are working with the Scrum, there are some things like epic, story, subtask, sprint. So let's start from the creating epic. So let's say for a mobile demo, I will create one epic, let's say user module. Let's say we have sign up and login module and profile management module in our application. Okay. So we can create epic name user module. And you can get, you can write whatever summary it fits. Like I can create a profile and manage my profile into the system. So when you tap on the create, it will create an epic for you. So now you can create backlog, story, bug, or task in that particular epic, which is related to user module. So for user module, we can say that we have a story like login screen, registration screen, profile screen. Okay, so let's start with the login screen. Let's say login module. So now I'm creating a story which is login module. So now this is story. You can also create bug task by clicking this. So now when you select this story, it will open one window here. So you can add description, you can create subtask, you can assign this story to anyone. There are so many other options like estimation, original estimation, time tracking, component, sprint, link to the sprint, labels. So after creating this story, you can write a proper description like as a user. valid password and username. You can also mention here that what kind of validation you will do while the development. You can also mention here some, you can attach the screenshot as well that what will be the design of the screen. So you can write each and everything related to the login module in the description, but you, it should be in a proper manner. After the creating story, the next step is creating subtask. So for the login module, what can be the subtask? Like UI implementation for the login screen. Next is API implementation. Next can be redirection. The home screen. Right, so this I have created as a subtask. Now here while estimating these things, we have some, we have more, I can say multiple way to estimate this task, right? So here I will give you one way, then we will ask Rizwan sir which way is better for estimating this task, because this task can be estimated with story point as well and the original estimation as well, right? So let's estimate, let's say a login module is a task of 14 hours. Then UI implementation subtask is of 4 hours. And I will mention 4 hours in the original estimate here. Whenever I will add original estimation, it will automatically give me 4 hours remaining in the time breaking, right? So that means we have not started this story now, right now, and we have 4 hours bandwidth for this task. Next, API implementation. Let's say API implementation is task of 6 hours. So we can mention here 6H. You can also mention here in week, day, hour, and minutes. And the last one, redirection to the home screen. Let's say it will take 2 hours. Okay, so now I have created one story, that is login module. So here I have not mentioned API creation part. For that we can either create another story or we can create another board which is more suitable for you. Now let's say I am creating another story, that is registration module has two task, UI implementation. Another one is API implementation. Okay, so now let's say we have completed the epic and backlog writing. Okay, so now when we will start the project, the next step will be to plan for the sprint. So sprint can be 2 week sprint or a 4 week sprint, right? So you can tap on create sprint and it will ask for the sprint planning. So in the sprint planning, you can drag and drop the backlog or the story you wanted to cover in the next sprint, right? Let's say I want to complete login module and registration module in my sprint. So I have drag and drop these two tasks here. Now I can tap on start sprint to start the sprint. It will ask me the sprint name. Then it will ask me this duration of the sprint. What can be the duration for this sprint, right? and it will ask, there are multiple options like 1 week, 2, 3, 4, custom. Then it will ask me the starting date. Let's say I want to start this sprint from the next Monday. So if I have selected 2 weeks, it will by default add 2 weeks in the end date. So by tapping on start, we can start the sprint. So now we have a sprint here, which cover two story, registration module and login module, where login module have 3 subtasks and registration have 2 subtasks. So here, this is role of TL. Now, whenever any developer who are working with you will start the work on this project, then you have to assign this story or this subtask to that person. For that, you can either click on the subtask and then you can mention here name of that person. Let's say Yunus, Nikunj or Tanuj. Whoever the person going to complete this task, you can mention their name here. You can also assign whole story to a person. If there is a thing that Yunus will complete this whole story, then you can assign directly this whole story to Yunus. So now, whenever development will be start, it will be Yunus' responsibility to move this that particular task or subtask into the in progress and done field whenever he is done with the task. Also, he has to log in their work. Let's say Yunus has started UI implementation, then he can move this into the in progress. And whenever he will done with the UI implementation, he will move that UI implementation to the done part. So once he move into the done part, he has to enter the log for that task, particular task. Let's say this task has been estimated for 4 hours. So Yunus has worked for 3 hours, then he can enter here 3 hours. So that green line means you have still 1 hour of bandwidth. If Yunus has taken 6 hours, then he can enter 6 hours. So that yellow lines means you have overhead in particular task. So that task marked as a done. So same like this one, he can move. So once now let's say we have completed all the subtasks at the end of the sprint. So whenever you will tap on the complete sprint, for so and so reason, so it is still in the to-do list. Okay, and I have completed 10 days of duration, but then I will mark this sprint as a complete sprint. Then it will tell me that you cannot mark this sprint as a complete. And it will ask me to either move that particular task to the backlog or plan for the next sprint. So once it is completed, it will create a graph from where you can monitor the delay or remaining values. So that's it. So also you can check that the epic you have created has now 2 completed tasks. There were 2 issues and both are completed. So this was the overview of the particular cycle which we have covered in the last session. So anyone has any questions here?
Umesh sir, any questions from you?
Okay. So, I think from this session, it seems all are in this session, right?
No, Sandeep.
All know very well.
No, Sandeep, but whenever we try these things on our own, then we can have more idea, but what kind of things we have got, what kind of things we have not got. I learned this thing from the last two sessions, and when I was preparing demo for this session, then I realized that so many things I did not know right now.
Yes. Okay. Right. So, that's why we are asking for the team. Anyone have an issue? Or you know very well the whole process of the Jira and task management. Just raise your question so you know very well and it's help you to understand it properly. Just create a question from the team.
Okay. Yeah, if somebody wants to do this exercise right now, let's say any one of you take any of your project, define anything for the epic, story, task and subtask, you tell us and we will create that same process here, same practical process here. We will create a epic, we will create a story, we will create a task, subtask, time log, sprint, everything. Anyone from you with any project with any epic, we are ready to do a practical task here, because once we will give it handover, then it would be tough to implement. So anyone can come up and we can do the practical one more round here.
Here I wanted to clear one thing to expert that whenever we mark any sprint complete, okay, and let's say I have two subtask or two task undone, which is not completed, and I am completing my sprint. What can be the impact to the performance on that particular sprint?
That is a good question from you. I think sprint is a time-bound event that should be completed. Whether the task of the sprint is completed or not, we have to complete that sprint and move to the next sprint, right? So the task in the current sprint will move to our next sprint, and this time and speed of our team will be affected. Let's say we have planned about the points. Let's say in terms of points, we have defined about 30 points to be covered in this sprint, and let's say we have two tasks which is not done. Then point related to those two tasks will be removed from our with a current sprint space. So we have done about 20 tasks in this sprint. Point in this sprint, and then we have to plan accordingly. Define the sprint based on that.
Okay.
So sprint is always going to complete, because sprint is not depending on the task. Task is there in a sprint. What was our mistake in that? How can we avoid that mistake in the future sprints and all that?
Okay. So next, sir, I have one more question. That let's say I have created these two epics, right? Product detail and wish list. Tell me where I am doing wrong. So product detail has story product detail, wish list has story wish list. Okay. And okay. Both have task UI implementation and API implementation.
Okay.
Now, where in the initial phase of our project, starting of the project, for the initial weeks, let's say a first sprint, we mostly do the UI implementation. We don't do the API implementation, right? We don't have our API ready. So we wait for the API team to provide us API. So in that initial phase, we start with the UI implementation. So how can I write the story sprint properly, which cover only the UI subtask?
Okay, let me give you the basic idea about the Scrum team first of all. Scrum team is a mixture of all kind of experts. We have the UI developers, we have the API developers, we have the backend developers, we have the mobile iOS basic developers as well. So that is all combined and define the Scrum team. That we have everything we are on board. So one can start with the UI development, but I think, I don't think that will affect the API development, because we know the field names and all these things. We know the DB, we know the API which to call. So I think they can start work parallelly as well. So I think UI and the backend API should not be holding each other, right? And
we have
QA as well in our team as well. So during that time, QA can write down the task cases can be prepared by the QA when you guys are doing the development and all. So I think no one should be hold each other in Scrum team. They should be do the work by their own. They don't need a help from outside. When they need help, they can take the help from someone expert from some other team. But all the work should be done by the Scrum team as well only, right? That is the basic concept of the Scrum. So to make a Scrum team and to run the business like a Scrum, we have to understand the Scrum first. How that is coming and all that. And the only thing I want to comment on our Jira training is we have the developers and we have the TLs or PMs, right? So the work of defining the project, creating a task should be done by TL or PM. Developers should be given only task. They should work only on the task right now. And they will move the task into the production, into the review, into the QA and all that. All the task definement, estimation should be done by TL and PM. So I think that project should be defined by PM or the TL. We are doing a training for them. That is a good thing. But I don't think they will be going to use this right now, because we are not going to give them this whole epic to create the whole story to create. That is responsibility of PM or TL, because developer need to know what they need to do, how that task should be done. That is the role of developer, right?
Yes. So my question is, sir, that how I can write the story and story epic. Let me give you one example what I'm trying to say.
Okay.
Let's say I want to start a sprint with the UI implementation task only. Okay. So I will cover login screen, registration screen, forgot password screen, all those screen UI, which can be possible in the first sprint.
Yes, okay. That can be possible. Yep.
Yeah. So I have written a product detail here as a epic. I have written a product detail as a story, and I have created two subtasks, UI implementation API. So now I am creating a sprint, planning for the sprint. So can I move this subtask from this story to the sprint?
Yes, you can move the subtask only. But I think in that case you have to. You have to go with two epics. One will be the front end UI, and the one will be the API, right? If you want to do that way, but when you start a Scrum or anything on the sprint, that sprint should be have all the tasks clear. Then only that sprint should be started, because we don't put any task which is not clear in a sprint. That task should be in the backlog. That task should be well defined, well estimated, and well understood by entire team. Otherwise, no point to adding that task in a sprint.
Okay, so that means we can create
two different tasks as well.
Task or two epics, one for the UI and one for the API for the initial. Yes.
That can also be done. But I don't think that will be the case in our management, because we always start with the developers of the UI and the API both, right? So I think that can be done parallelly both.
No, but sir, mostly in case, if we say, let's say for mostly in 1 week or 2 week, we don't have API to start, right? So in that time, we mostly used to start with the UI task first, project setup and UI task. Then we will move to the parallelly that like API and UI. So we can do one thing that we can write for initial stages of initial functionalities. We can create UI and API separate epic, and for then onwards we can write epic like module wise.
Okay, that can also be done, but I think that is not a best practice to do, because when we define a sprint in a Scrum board, we have to have a Scrum team as well. That has a UI developer, that has an API developer, that has a QA defined for that project, that sprint. So it is the best practice of a Scrum, but it is up to us, because I know in our size of company that may happen. That ये जो है उसको पहले खत्म कर दो, बाद में देखेंगे ये होगा ये होगा ये होगा. In that case, I think Scrum should not be applied. Kanban board will be the best board for that. We can define the task of a UI separately. We can define the task of API separately. When we have the developers available for them, they can start to work on that.
Okay. So anyone else? Does anyone have any questions?
Let me correct here. If I'm not wrong, as you said, we need to create separate. No.
I'm not getting your voice. Hello.
Wait, we can hear you.
I think Sandeep is asking something.
Yes, tell me. Hello.
Sandeep, your voice is breaking.
Yes, it's completely breaking. We are not able to hear you.
Okay, tell us, Sandeep sir, like settle down. Anybody has any other questions? Akash Murodia and Akash Manjukya, do you guys have any questions?
No, right now we don't have any question. Actually, Vivek has explained very well, and also Rizwan sir is helping him. So we got idea very well. And once, as Vivek said, once we do practically, at that time, if we have any question, then Vivek is also there to help us.
Sounds good. Sagar, do you have any questions into this?
No, sir. Actually, I'm asking one question to Rizwan, sir, that he said that, actually, I want to say that Scrum is the best when all tasks should be mentioned very well, and all developers which are assigned to that task should be going to be work parallelly, right?
No, it's not like that. I think Scrum is the best for when we have the complex things like in a project. Like we want to develop an app like a Flipkart, so we don't know what we need to include in that, all the kind of stuff. But when we have a Scrum using on a project, we have to define certain tasks for our next 2 to 3 sprint. That this thing has been clear, and that thing would be done by that kind of developers and all that. We have to define the Scrum team as well for them. Right. So when we're using a Scrum, we have to have a Scrum team defined in that.
Okay. Okay.
Project has many uncertainty. There. Known to us, a PM or our client could give any changes on that. We have to constantly give the update to the client. They will review our work and they will give you feedback. And based on that feedback, our next sprint or next task might change. So in that change, we have to add that task into the backlog, and we have to define that task completely very well. And then that task will be there in the next coming sprint. So when we are using some, that sprint should be defined perfectly. That sprint should not be changed in between. There should not be any change to be taken in that sprint. And sprint cannot be canceled as well. If they want to cancel the sprint, then we have to do the replanning again. Because if there is something, something like let me give you the big example, like our client is changing his business or just going to close his business. Then also, in that case, we should cancel the sprint and start all over again, right? Okay. So in a Scrum, okay.
So, मुझे एक बेसिक आप सबको समझाना है स्क्रम एंड कानबान का डिफरेंस क्या है नॉट इन आईटी इंडस्ट्री और एनीथिंग बट ये एक वर्किंग मेथोडोलॉजी है
एग्जैक्टली
राइट सो कानबान क्या है मैं एक ऐसा नहीं है स्क्रम या कानबान सिर्फ ये ही आईटी इंडस्ट्री में यूज हो सकता है ये कोई भी इंडस्ट्री में कहीं पे भी यूज हो सकता है सो कानबान क्या है फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं कार लेकर एक एरिया के कोई गैरेज में जा रहा हूँ और मैं 10 पॉइंट्स में लिख कर दे रहा हूँ पेपर पर मुझे ये चीज रिपेयर करवाना है या ये चीज मुझे करवाना है तो जैसे ही वो पेपर आता है वो लोग काम शुरू कर देते हैं राइट सो कानबान में आपके पास कोई बैकलॉग नहीं होता कोई बकेट नहीं होता और एक अनदर मेथोडोलॉजी कि मैं मारुति के कोई ऑथोराइज शोरूम में मैं कार रिपेयरिंग के लिए ले जाता हूँ तो क्या होता है वहां पर उनके पास नंबर ऑफ कार्स क्यू में रहते हैं राइट उसके सामने नंबर ऑफ इंजीनियर्स प्लांट्स रहते हैं वो लोग आपको पहले एडवांस में बताते हैं सर हम आपका कार का इन्वेस्टिगेशन करेंगे आपको एस्टीमेट देंगे फिर आपका काम शुरू करेंगे तब तक इंजीनियर इन्वॉल्व नहीं होता तब तक अनदर डिजाइन टीम स्पेयर पार्ट टीम वगैरह वगैरह इन्वॉल्व होता है तो वहां पे एक बकेट रहता है वो लोग बकेट में काम करते रहते हैं फिर जो डेवलपमेंट में देना है इंजीनियरिंग में वही जाता है और उसके बेस से वो स्प्रिंट होकर फिर कस्टमर को डिलीवरेबल टाइम मिलता है सो स्क्रम एंड कानबान के बीच में यही डिफरेंस है कानबान में आपके पास कोई बकेट नहीं है जो आया करते जाओ बैकलॉग जैसा नहीं है स्क्रम में बैकलॉग है आप बैकलॉग में एपिक कर सकते हैं स्टोरी कर सकते हैं टास्क सब टास्क फिर मुझे इसमें से क्या पोर्शन कितना स्प्रिंट में सिलेक्ट करके आगे देना है तभी वो डेवलपर्स को पता चलेगा कानबान में तो जैसे ही एड करूंगा सबको पता चल जाएगा प्री प्लानिंग जैसा कानबान में कुछ नहीं हो सकता स्क्रम में ही
हाँ सर इसमें आपको थोड़ा सा मैं बीच में रोका सॉरी फॉर दैट बट इसमें एग्जांपल आपने अच्छा दिया बहुत अच्छा एग्जांपल दिया है उसमें आपके एग्जाम्पल में थोड़ा चीज ऐड करना चाहूंगा अगर आपका कांच का आपका कार का कांच टूट गया है मान लो जो आपको दिखता है कि कांच को रिपेयर करना है आपकी गाड़ी की हेडलाइट टूट गई आपको दिखता है गाड़ी की हेडलाइट टूट गई मतलब दो टास्क आपके पास है दो टास्क डिफाइन है क्या करना अभी पता है तो वो जाएगा कैनबैन में कि इसका कांच रिपेयर करो गाड़ी का हेडलाइट तोड़ डाल दो ठीक है अगर आपकी गाड़ी के इंजन में कुछ प्रॉब्लम है गाड़ी बीच में बंद हो जाती है कुछ स्टार्ट नहीं होता है क्या इंजन में कुछ हो गया मान लो आपको पता नहीं आप ले गए गैरेज में गैरेज वालों को पता नहीं है तो वो चीज जाएगी स्क्रम में क्योंकि उसको पता नहीं है वो चीज चेक करेगा वो उसमें जाके
करेक्ट दैट इज कॉल्ड प्रायोरिटी कि लेट्स से मेरे कोई प्रोजेक्ट में पेमेंट गेटवे बंद हो गया है और क्लाइंट्स पे नहीं कर पा रहे तो मुझे वो चीज कानबान में डालकर इमरजेंसी में सॉल्व करना है
इमरजेंसी में सॉल्व नहीं मतलब आपको आपको टास्क डिफाइन आपको पता है, आपके पास कुछ कोई कोई भी कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी नहीं, अनसर्टिनिटी नहीं है, तब जाएगा कैनबन में। कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी है, अनसर्टिनिटी, आपको पता नहीं है कैसे करना है क्या करना है, तब वो जाएगा स्क्रम में। बाद में आपको एस्टिमेट देगा कि इतने इतने पार्ट्स इतने इतने बदलने पड़ेंगे, उसके बेस पे आप काम करोगे। दैट इज
करेक्ट,
मेन बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन कैनबन बोर्ड एंड स्क्रम बोर्ड।
करेक्ट। अनदर एस्पेक्ट है कि साइन इन स्क्रीन पर साइन इन बटन में साइन इन स्मॉल में लिखा है, क्लाइंट कह रहा है कि मुझे कैपिटल में लिखना है, बट वो इम्पैक्ट नहीं हो रहा है उससे, कोई लाइव प्रोडक्ट में या यूजर्स को कोई इम्पैक्ट नहीं हो रहा है, प्रॉब्लम नहीं हो रहा है, वो स्टिल क्लिक कर कर अपना प्रोसेस तो कर ही सकता है, उसको सिर्फ स्पेलिंग या टाइपो चेंज करना है। सो दैट यू कैन प्लान इन स्क्रम, इट इज ये प्रायोरिटी नहीं है। जैसे हीट लैंप टूट गया तो आपको रात को ड्राइव नहीं कर सकते, तो ये कानमान में डालना पड़ेगा, पर कार का आपको लेदर सीट कवर चेंज करना है, नहीं करेंगे एक महीने तक भी चल सकता है। सो व्हाट कुड बी इन द स्क्रम, दैट इज आल्सो डिपेंड ऑन द प्रायोरिटी।
स्क्रम एक्चुअली आपने जो पहले बताया वही सही था कि स्क्रम और कैनबन दोनों एक काम करने का सलीका है, मतलब कौन से सलीके से आप काम कर रहे हो उसमें,
राइट,
और कौन सी चीज को किस में डालना चाहिए, दैट इज द पॉइंट। मतलब वो बटन चेंज करना या कार का सीट कवर चेंज करना वो तो अपने ऊपर है, कौन सा बोर्ड यूज करना।
एंड ब्रेन वायर में हमारे प्रोजेक्ट का नेचर के हिसाब से हम लोग डेवलपमेंट के लिए स्क्रम सिलेक्ट कर रहे हैं, क्यूए के लिए कानबान सिलेक्ट कर रहे हैं। हम लोग क्यूए के लिए भी स्क्रम सिलेक्ट कर सकते हैं और डेवलपमेंट के लिए भी कानबान कर सकते हैं।
अगर आप स्क्रम यूज कर रहे हो तो स्क्रम टीम होती है, स्क्रम टीम में क्यूए पर्सन मस्ट है, वो तो होना ही चाहिए, तो वो आपको साथ स्क्रम में क्यू होना ही चाहिए, वो पैरेलल क्यू होगा। अभी क्या हो रहा है अपने अपने केस में क्या हो रहा है, पूरा मॉड्यूल खत्म हो गया, पूरा प्रोजेक्ट खत्म हो गया, उसके बाद हम क्यूए करने जाते हैं, वैसा नहीं होता स्क्रम में। स्क्रम में आपको हर एक स्प्रिंट का क्यूए पड़ता है। स्क्रम में स्प्रिंट का मतलब है कि स्प्रिंट खत्म होने के बाद आपको कुछ ना कुछ आउटपुट मिलेगा जो आप देख सकते हो, जो आप चेक कर सकते हो, उसके ऊपर फीडबैक दे सकते हो। दैट इज मेन बेसिक डिफरेंस बिटवीन कैनबन एंड स्क्रम। स्क्रम में स्प्रिंट होती है, ईच आफ्टर ईच स्प्रिंट यू हैव टू हैव समथिंग टू सी, समथिंग टू जज, समथिंग टू रिव्यू, राइट। उसके बाद ही आपका वो जो उसका जो रिव्यू होगा, उसका मीटिंग होगा, स्क्रम आपकी स्प्रिंट खत्म होने के बाद मीटिंग होता है, स्प्रिंट उसको बोलते हैं स्प्रिंट रेट्रोस्पेक्टिव। उसमें आपको डिफाइन करना है क्या क्या स्प्रिंट में हो गया, क्या गलत थे, क्या 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 सही करना है, क्या सही था उसको हमको कंटिन्यू करना है, वो सब एस्पेक्ट को हम देख के बाद में आगे बढ़ते हैं। और हर एक स्प्रिंट के बाद अपना रिव्यू होता है, स्प्रिंट का रिव्यू होता है कि भाई इसमें कौन से टास्क खत्म हुए, कौन से टास्क आगे जा सकते हैं, कौन से टास्क अपना मेन जो अपना जो साइट पे लाइव जा सकते हैं, ऐसे होता है, राइट। वो चीज है स्क्रम। अगर आप कैनबन यूज करो, कैनबन इज स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड, आपके पास सारा टास्क डिफाइन है, सब कुछ डिफाइन है, दैट इज फाइन, तो आप कैनबन जा सकते हो। लेकिन व्हेन यू डिफाइन अ स्क्रम, देयर हैज टू बी टीम, देयर हैज टू बी सेल्फ ड्रिवन टीम। वो टीम को बाहर से कोई डिस्टर्ब नहीं करे, वो टीम में से कोई किसी को कोई बंदा खींचे नहीं, कोई बंदा बीच में से ऐड नहीं होगा, ऐसा नहीं होता स्क्रम में। अगर 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 ऐसा करोगे तो फिर आपकी स्प्रिंट कभी खत्म ही नहीं होगी टाइम पे, कभी कभी दो वीक होगी, कभी तीन वीक होगा, कभी चार वीक हो जाएगा स्प्रिंट में, और स्क्रम बीच में रहेगा नहीं उस टाइम पे,
राइट। सो अभी सबको आइडिया आ गया व्हाट इज स्क्रम एंड व्हाट इज कानबान, अभी क्लियर हो गया उसका मेथोडोलॉजी।
लगते सबको समझ में आ गया सही से,
कोई सब समझ में आ गया, ये कंसीडर करके हम आगे अभी वेटेज के लिए जा सकते हैं।
हास्य ये पॉइंट में यहाँ पे ऐड करना चाहूंगा, रिजवान सर और हास्य
बोलो बोलो।
जैसे लास्ट पॉइंट पर विवेक ने जो क्वेरी बताया कि जैसे हमारे ब्रेन वायर के डेवलपमेंट के हिसाब से एक एग्जांपल लिया कि पहले हम यूआई कंसीडर करते हैं, अगर कोई यूआई पार्ट रेडी है तो पहले फोकस करते हैं। सपोज तीन मेरी स्टोरी है, तीनों स्टोरी की यूआई पार्ट मेरे को कंसीडर करना है अभी स्प्रिंट के लिए, राइट। तो मैं तीनों टास्क जैसे प्रोडक्ट के 20 और होगी, तीनों के यूआई पार्ट मेरे को पहले खत्म करना है, तीनों के लिए मैं स्टोरी अलग बनाऊंगा वो अच्छा रहेगा, या अलग से सब टास्क में एक स्प्रिंट में डाल सकता हूँ, तीनों का यूआई पार्ट का सब टास्क मेरे को पहले स्प्रिंट में लेना है, यूआई बाद में करना है, एपी बाद में करना है,
वो तो
इसमें कौन सा रहेगा, अलग अलग स्टोरी बनाए तो अच्छा रहेगा।
अलग स्टोरी नहीं, मतलब आपको सेम एक ही स्टोरी में डाल दो कि यूआई डिफाइनेशन, मतलब यूआई डेफिनेशन उसमें आप यूआई में डाल दो, हर एक का लॉगिन स्क्रीन का डिजाइन, ये इसका यूआई, विशलिस्ट का डिजाइन, ये उसका रजिस्ट्रेशन का डिजाइन, इसका यूआई, तो सेम स्टोरी में भी चलेगा। अगर वो टास्क डिफाइन है कंप्लीट, आपको पता है ये डिजाइन करना है, ये हो गया खत्म,
राइट।
बट आई थिंक अभी जो आप कर रहे हो,
फर्स्ट वीक तक हमें एपीआई का सपोर्ट नहीं मिलता, तब तक फर्स्ट वीक सेकंड वीक हम लोग सिर्फ यूआई का स्प्रिंट कर सकते हैं, देन कंबाइन कर सकते हैं,
देन कंबाइन कर सकते हैं, और बाद में उसमें आपको डालना है, आपको उसमें मर्ज का एक आपको टास्क बनाना है कि आप यूआई के साथ एपीआई मर्ज करके उसका उसका टास्क भी बनेगा नेक्स्ट स्प्रिंट में,
और उसी स्प्रिंट को हम लोग क्लोज करके एक्सटेंड भी कर सकते हैं अनदर टास्क ऐड करके। फर्स्ट एक यूआई का एक वीक का टास्क कर लिया, स्प्रिंट स्टार्ट कर दिया, स्टॉप हो गया, उसमें नया भी ऐड ऑन करके स्प्रिंट हम कंटिन्यू कर सकते
हैं। स्प्रिंट में ऐसा नहीं होता, सब स्प्रिंट ऐसा होता है, स्प्रिंट एक डिफाइन है, यदि आपने स्प्रिंट डिफाइन कर लिया 15 डेज तो हर एक स्प्रिंट 15 डेज का ही होगा, फिर आपको उसमें टास्क एडजस्ट करना है कि ये 15 डेज में क्या होगा, आप स्प्रिंट का लेंथ चेंज नहीं कर सकते, कभी 15 डेज कभी 1 वीक कभी 3 वीक ऐसा नहीं होता।
अनदर टेक्निक भी ये कर सकते हैं कि एक साथ में हम लोग यूआई एंड एपीआई टास्क बना सकते हैं स्प्रिंट में स्टोरीज के साथ, राइट? स्प्रिंट खत्म होते हैं हम सिर्फ यूआई पे कॉन्सेंट्रेट करेंगे, जो एपीआई के जो टास्क है सब टास्क है उसको नेक्स्ट स्प्रिंट में हम लोग कैरी ऑन कर सकते हैं।
वो भी कर सकते हो, लेकिन अगेन अगर आप एपीआई और ये जो अलग करोगे तो आपको दूसरा टास्क डिफाइन करना पड़ेगा, दो कंबाइन करके मर्ज करके उसको चेक करने वाला टास्क,
राइट? So, ये एक एट द एंड यही है कि जो लीड कर रहा है उसको कैसे मैनेज करना है, जैसे मल्टीपल टीम है, सो मोबाइल से जो लीड कर रहा है वो एपीआई से कैसे, कौन लीड कर रहा है, उन दोनों के बीच में अंडरस्टैंडिंग और टीम मैनेजमेंट एंड ओवरऑल प्रोजेक्ट आउटपुट कैसे करेंगे, कैसे रिलीज अचीव करेंगे, इसके ऊपर डिपेंड है। यू कैन टेक एनी कॉन्फ़िगरेशन।
इसमें आपको मैं सिर्फ एक पॉइंट और ऐड करना चाहूंगा, अगर आप ऐसे डिफाइन करोगे तो आपको क्लाइंट को या प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट अपने या तो टॉप अथॉरिटी जैसे आपको मर्ज को समझाना पड़ेगा कि अभी सिर्फ यूआई होगा बाद में ये होगा, बिकॉज जनरली स्क्रम का मतलब है कि आप ऐसा कोई चीज बनाओ, स्प्रिंट का मतलब है आफ्टर एंड ऑफ ईच स्प्रिंट देयर शुड बी अ समथिंग दैट कैन बी यूजफुल, वो होना चाहिए स्प्रिंट के बाद। अगर आप खाली यूआई बना रहे हो तो खाली यूआई यूजफुल नहीं है, देख लिया सिर्फ आपने देख लिया, फंक्शनल और यूजफुल चीज होनी चाहिए स्प्रिंट के बाद। आपको डिफाइन ऐसे करना है, आपको टीम कॉम्बिनेशन ऐसे करना है कि साथ में ही हो जाए, वो बेस्ट है, बाद में अपने ऊपर है, बाद में फिर आप नहीं कर सकते तो फिर वो तो ऑब्वियस है, फिर आपको करना ही पड़ेगा, आदमी बंदा फ्री बैठा है तो उसको काम करवाना पड़ेगा,
राइट? वन मोर पॉइंट ऐड करना चाहूंगा, जैसे स्टोरी का जो भी नाम हम डिफाइन करते हैं उसका डिस्क्रिप्शन या नेमिंग कन्वेंशन किस तरह होना चाहिए,
नेमिंग कन्वेंशन आपका क्लियर होना चाहिए कि स्टोरी में क्या है, आपको देख के मालूम पड़ना चाहिए कि ये स्टोरी में हम क्या बात करते हैं, राइट? और उसके हिसाब से आपको स्टोरी में टास्क डिफाइन करना है, और ईच एंड एवरी टास्क को वेल डिफाइन होना चाहिए कि आदमी बंदा देख के उसको समझ ले, और कोई भी स्प्रिंट चालू होने से पहले वो टास्क को आपको समझाना है, पब्लिक जो भी आपके डेवलपर्स हो डेवलपर्स टास्क को रीड करेंगे समझेंगे उसके बाद ही काम चालू करना, ऐसा नहीं कि आज आया चालू कर दे, ऐसा नहीं, आपको उसको जो आपका जो टीम का जो लीडर है या टीएल है उसको सीनियर बंदा सब मिलकर बैठ के उसको डिफाइन करेंगे, डिसाइड करेंगे कि ये बंदा ये करेगा बस।
राइट, तो जैसे एग्जांपल ले अभी प्रोडक्ट डिटेल जैसे लिखा है उसका नेमिंग कन्वेंशन इस तरह होना चाहिए पूरा डिटेल में कि यूजर कैन टैप ऑन दिस एक्शन एंड दैट कैन शो अ फुल डिटेल ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट, इस तरह का कोई डिस्क्रिप्टिव नाम होना चाहिए, राइट? स्टोरी का नाम जब डालते हैं
तो स्टोरी का नाम तो बड़ा प्रोडक्ट डिटेल बराबर है, आपको स्टोरी के पॉइंट के अंदर लिखना है कि भाई फ्रॉम दिस पेज मतलब लिस्टिंग पेज या होम पेज से प्रोडक्ट यहां पर क्लिक करेगा देन इट विल कम टू दिस पेज, और बाद में फिर ये पेज पे कौन से एलिमेंट्स है, ये पेज का डिजाइन कैसा है, ये पेज पे कोई लॉजिक है, प्राइस का कोई लॉजिक है, प्राइस का स्पेशल प्राइस और ऐसा लॉजिक है, तो वो डिफाइन होना चाहिए कम्प्लीटली, मतलब ऐसी कोई भी चीज नहीं हो कि जो वहाँ पर डिफाइन नहीं हो, आपको डिजाइन से लेके फंक्शनैलिटी से लेके एवरीथिंग दैट शुड बी देयर इन स्टोरी पॉइंट एंड दैट स्टोरी पॉइंट शुड बी वेल एस्टिमेटेड एज वेल,
और दैट विल गो इनटू डिस्क्रिप्शन,
यस,
होल फ्लो,
यस, द होल फ्लो विद द डिजाइन विद द फंक्शनल विद द यूज केस विद द फंक्शनल रिक्वायरमेंट एवरीथिंग, अगर आपको जो जो भी करते हो वहाँ पर, अगर आपके प्रोडक्ट डिटेल पेज पे रिव्यूज है और वो रिव्यू पे थर्ड पार्टी से आ रहे हैं तो थर्ड पार्टी का एपीआई कौन से थर्ड पार्टी से आएगा, कैसे यूज करना है, एपीआई से यूज करना है या डीबीएस सेव है, एवरीथिंग शुड बी रिटन ओवर देयर। अगर टास्क डिफाइन नहीं है तो उसको स्प्रिंट में मत डालो, अगर टास्क को अगर डिवाइड कर सकते हो तो सिर्फ डिवाइड करो कि प्रोडक्ट डिटेल पेज ओनली दिस पार्ट रिव्यू, बाकी स्प्रिंट में आ जाएगा वैसा। Understood? When you define a task, that should be defined, that should be estimated perfectly, correctly. And we have to make sure that that task should be done in that estimate only. If you have a doubt, hai, koi ambiguity, hai, to wo discuss karwa ke. Aisa nahi ki task chalu kar do, chalu nahi karna hai.
Practically, in large scale, जो स्क्रम मास्टर होता है वो नॉन टेक्निकल बंदा होता है जो प्रोडक्ट ओनर होता है और वो यहाँ पे टाइटल में कैसे टाइपो केस हैंडल करना है कैमल कोड में लिखना है वो कुछ उसको पता नहीं रहता क्योंकि अगर मैं टेक्निकल बंदा हूँ मैं अगर कोई स्टोरी बना रहा हूँ कोई टास्क बना रहा हूँ तो मैं टेक्निकल बंदा हूँ तो मुझे पहले ये टेंशन होगा कि ये मैं 8 घंटे में कम्प्लीट कर पाऊंगा ये 12 घंटे में कम्प्लीट कर पाएगा डिजाइनर ये 16 घंटे में क्यूए कंप्लीट कर पाएगा सो ही शुड बी द नॉन टेक्निकल पर्सन रिगार्डलेस ऑफ राइटिंग एनीथिंग टेक्निकल
नो इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट आपने जो बताया उसमें चेंज करना चाहूंगा स्क्रम मास्टर अलग बंदा है और पीओ जो बोलते हैं वो अलग बंदा है स्क्रम मास्टर इज डिफरेंट पर्सन और वो जो पीओ अलग डिफरेंट पर्सन वैसा और स्क्रम टीम होती है पीओ इज अ पार्ट ऑफ स्क्रम टीम पीओ कैन हैंडल मोर देन 2 or 3 टीम्स एज वेल बट सबसे आइडियल सिनेरियो है कि एक पीओ के साथ एक टीम हो या तो मैक्सिमम 2 टीम हो
एंड पीओ पीओ इज द एंड पॉइंट ऑफ क्लाइंट राइट
यस पीओ इज द एंड पॉइंट ऑफ द क्लाइंट ही विल बी वो पूरा बैकलॉग डिफाइन वो करेगा स्टोरी पॉइंट वो डिफाइन करेगा वो मतलब बीए का बंदा बोल सकते हैं बीए बंदा दैट इज बेस्ट अपने अपने यहां पर बीए जो होता है वो जो बीए जो होता है वो क्लाइंट का बिजनेस समझेगा उसको क्या चाहिए वो समझेगा उसके बेस पे वो उसको डिफाइन करेगा बैकलॉग के आइटम्स वो सारे आइटम्स डिफाइन करेगा बाद में जो स्क्रम टीम वो बैकलॉग के आइटम को रिव्यू करेगी उसको एस्टिमेट करेगी बाद में स्क्रम टीम के ऊपर है कि कौन सी आइटम उसमें ली जाए स्प्रिंट में कितनी इतनी आइटम स्प्रिंट में लेंगे और स्प्रिंट ऐसा डिफाइन करो कि स्प्रिंट का लेंथ हमेशा सेम हो लेंथ वेरी नहीं करना है हमको उस पर टास्क वेरी करना है कि ये टास्क आएगा ये टास्क आएगा ये टास्क आएगा
राइट
या तो टाइम खत्म हो गया अभी हम लोग करेंगे वो एस्टीमेट के नेक्स्ट सैटरडे रखते हैं
नहीं नहीं सर
हां वेटेज शॉर्टेज यस स्टोरी वेटेज करना है सर
करना है वेटेज
यस सर
इतना 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 हार्ड नहीं है वेरी सिंपल थिंग इतना कोई आप जो भी तो अभी डिस्कस किया उसमें आ गया वेटेज में
प्लीज सो दैट्स व्हाई वी वांटेड टू कवर दैट अप एज वेल
ओके ओके इन द स्टोरी प्लेन द वेटेज अभी जो हमने डिस्कस किया अभी तक कि पीओ क्या करता है स्क्रम मास्टर क्या करता है स्क्रम टीम क्या करती है So first of all, understand the Scrum team. Scrum team is the combination of developer, which is all the developers. UI, if you need UI, UI developer, if you need API, there should be API, if you need QA, it should be QA developer, right? So we have to define each and every task. We have the story in our from the backlog item. The whole Scrum team combines to that, and then they give the and they review the story and then try to give you the estimate. Let me share my screen with you. I have just brief of what document I have prepared for this. Okay. Let me know when you guys can see my screen.
Yes, we can see.
Okay. Story point definition is based on these things. Uncertainty, how much uncertain task it is. Let's say we have to define a login screen. And then in that login, that will be OTP based. That will be API based or that will be database driven. What is all that? If we have the complexity, like if the task is too complex, like someone, let's say we have the new API to be developed, that API might be in a remote place that have the connection issue, all that issue can become, right? So there is a complexity. After we define both of these uncertainty and complexity, we have to define a solution. So after we define a solution that this task will be done in this way, this many screens are there, this many API will be there, this many variation will be there. After that, all these things defined on the paper, we have the complete defined solution is there. When we have the solution, we can give the amount of work to be done on that solution, right? So this is basic estimate of our day-to-day task as well. The same thing is there in story estimate as well. But in case of story estimation in a Scrum, we have certain members in a team. Like we have 4 to 5 members in a team. Each member will give their input on that story. That say, like the UI developer will say that I will need this much time. API will say this, I will need this much time. And the QA will say that I will need this much time to define this task. And that all the team comes to be, comes to, let's say, a certain amount of estimate, like they on a login, we have, let's say, 16 hours is coming, right? 16 hours task is there to define a UA, to do a QA, everything is there. If they just define 16 hours, that is fine. But if some of the team members might have doubt that that it might take 16 hours or more, then at that time, you need to give them brief about the scope that this much will be there. They have to solve each of the query of them, and then they might become to about 24 hours with all testing and all that. So this 24 hours is been there for that story only, right? So we have defined this 24 hours. Based on this, we can define a story point as well. That is our estimate of hours that will go with each task. It will go with each task, right? It will go with task. But we can define a story point as well. Story points is a very vague term. There is a certain thing in a story point. They have defined some numbers. Like we can say these numbers ranging from this one, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 20, 40, 100, and big. Big means there is a very big. We don't know the estimate. First comes this question mark. We don't know the estimate. Then it comes to big. There is a very big task. Then if task is very big, we have to split that task into smaller tasks that we can estimate. Like in this, we have this login model. We can have the big task called user profile, right? User profile is a big task. User profile might have login, then again registration, then again call profile update, right? And then again call, we can say change password. All these things can be there in user profile, right? Then again, we can have something else, my orders, let's say we have this many things. So first of all, this user profile will fall into question mark. Then we can say it's a very big task. Then we will define each one of these stories like this. Then we will define this login is about 24 hours has been there, login. Now, based on this, we will give certain number on this. From this number, we fix set of numbers, 1, 200 and big. From this set of numbers, we can give certain number to this story. So let's say we have 24 hours, we will give the number to this story, let's say 8 numbers, right? Now, come to this registration part. We have defined everything. We have defined like that form will be there, that the field of the form will be there. They will be saved in API or in our database or in a remote database. Everything should be there. And that estimate might come around 64 hours. So based on this, this was 24 hours and this is 64 hours, right? So based on this, we can give a story point of this can be 20, right? Again, we have the profile update story. This is, again, we can say about 32 hours worth. So we can define a story point 13 to this. And then again, come a change password. That will be a simple task of a change password that is only at 16 hours. So we'll define a story point 5 to this. These are the numbers. There is a number definition. And based on this number, we will define each story point like 8, 10, 13, 5. So in this sprint, we will have 13 plus 18, 20, 38 plus 8. 38 plus 8 means we have about 46 points are there, right? This is where we have defined this story. This user comes story, it comes to, that comes to total estimate of 48 points. This is a point, this is not ours. Understood? Guys? Hello?
Yes, understood.
Understood. This is a point actually. This is not actually ours, right? And based on this point, we have to define a scrum. Sprint on that, because in this sprint, how many tasks we can cover? Like we based on our previous estimates or the previous experience, we can define the length of the sprint as well, that we can complete about 30 points in a 2-week sprint. We can complete next 30 points in the next 30 points. And based on this point, we have to define a sprint. Right? A sprint length will be fixed. So let's say we have 2-week sprint. Based on our previous experience, we can define if we have the pace of our team, pace, or we can say velocity of our team. The velocity means how many points a team can finish in the given time. It's about 20, right? So in that case, we have to define to finish this point, we have to define 3 sprints, right? 3 sprints will be there. 3 sprints will be needed to finish the story. This is the basic method of defining the story point. And now comes to the estimate. How this estimate should come. We have the past experience as well, that this many tasks has took that much time. We can have all the details, like a login screen design has been there, API details has been there, use cases are there, test cases are there. All this test case should be defined. And based on that, we should define the estimation of that. To define these numbers, this 8, 20, 30, there are some methods. Based on the previous experience of our team, we can have this planning focus, which is, I explain is this. These are the numbers of focus. Based on this, based on our estimate, we can define the point to each of the story, like this login 24 hours, we have given 8 points. Registration, we have given 20 points. So profile update, we have given 13 points. Change password, we have given 5 points, based on this. So based on that, we can define the given story point. And when we define a story point estimation, the whole team should sit together. They should read and they should understand the task. They will give their own estimate. Let's say we have the 5 members in a team. One, 2, 3, 4, and 5. One member will say that it will take about 20 hours. Other will say it will be done in 16 hours. Like some super developer like Hasia will say it will be done in 60 hours. One will say it will take 32 hours. One will say, let's say it will, he will say that 20 hours or 24 hours. And based on that, and the last fellow will say it will take 12 hours. So in that case, a project owner needs to understand, needs to define each and every task again with them, that why do you think this much hours will take? And based on this, they will have to, if these 5 members are not agree to certain tasks, they will be taken as a maximum hours for from this on a safe side. If the task is very uncertain, they feel that they are, there might be API issues, there might be connection issues, there might be some uncertain issues might come. So after that definition, they have to take a maximum from this hours, right? This is one method. This will be a maximum hours will be taken from this, and that will come to 32 hours. And based on these 32 hours, they will give a point to the story. Let's say we can give the point to the story, like from this 13, we have given 13 point to 32 hours, like this. And based on this 13 points, we have to define another stories, and all these stories will take that way. This is a planning focus of the Delphi method. This is one method. The next method is the expert judgment. That is what we are following right now. Senior manager or the PM or TL will give the estimate of a task, that this task will take that much of, right? That will be the expert judgment method. Well, they can define each and everything and then give us the estimate that this task might be completed in the 24 hours only. And the last method is about we can have PERT method as well. PERT stands for the program evolution review technique. The best example I can give in the PERT technique is we have to think about positive and negative both, and the most ideal situation as well. In a worst situation, it will take this much hours. In the ideal situation, in the favorable situation, we have this much hours, and in the ideal situation, in the ideal, we have this much hours. Based on that, we have the formula like this. I will give the example of this. Let's say we have to. I am living in South Bhopal, and from South Bhopal, I want to go to our office every day. And when I go to office, I have to go by road, and there might be too much traffic on the road. There might be empty road, like in this lockdown, we have the empty roads. And some other days we have the slight traffic, slight signals will be there. So let's say this optimistic situation, optimistic means lockdown situation, we have the empty roads, and we have the pessimistic things like there are too many traffic on the road. So that will take longer time for me to reach the office. And we have the most likely situation where in the normal days we reach in the time that certain things will come, but that will be absorbable. So that can be achievable. So in that case, let's say I have too many traffic, then it will take 90 minutes. If I have no traffic, then it will take 30 minutes. But ideally, it should take me 60 minutes, right? That is what we have. So we have the three things. Optimistic is we can say 30 minutes. Pessimistic, we can say 90 minutes it will take if there is too much traffic. And most likely, that is our normal routine day will take about 60 minutes. Okay. So in that case, based on this formula, we have to define this optimistic plus 4 most likely plus P divided by 6. This is the formula of giving the judgment of the story point. So we can say 30, 90, 60. That we have 30 plus 240 plus 90 divided by 6. It will come 60. So I think that story point should be defined a weightage of 60 points or 60 hours. So based on this, we have to define each and every story point, and based on estimation of story point previous experience, we have to define a sprint. Do you guys have any question?
Not as of now.
Do you understand all the three methods of giving estimate of a sprint?
Yes.
Estimate should be there on a sprint only, not on the whole project, because whole project is not defined yet. In terms of Scrum, we have to define each sprint and the estimate of a story point. So let me give you an example on the backlog. Let's say we have the backlog items about 1, backlog items 2, backlog items 3. We have about n up to 9 n backlog items, right? So always the backlog items will be this first three backlog items will be defined, will be well defined. Like this is a story point 20. This is also defined as story point. This story has been defined as a 40 points. This story will be defined as a 30 points again, but this n will be a question mark because it is not yet defined. Same way, BC 100 might be a very big something like this. This will be a picture in a normal backlog item, and again the top backlog item will be well defined, and we will always take a first from the backlog item before. This will be taken into a sprint. So in our board, we have the three things like backlog. This is a backlog. Then this three will be moved to to-do. right? After that to do, this will come into picture in next page. And during this thing is working, PO will be going to define each and every backlog item. He will give the estimate of this item by first of all his estimate, but the final estimate should be given by the team only. You will give the vague idea of the estimate that I think that this task might take this much hours or this much hours, but ultimately that should be defined by the team because ultimately they have to work on the task.
Got it, sir. Thank you so much for the insights of how to give estimations, what are the different ways to work inside it. This is really helpful. And we really understand that, okay, it should be always estimations of a sprints that we are doing, not the complete project. And that is one of the reason as well, that whenever we say that, okay, we are like for all the our, let's say, like to be a very transparent for all the projects that we are doing, we are not doing all the other agile projects because we have a fixed scope, fixed timings and everything. So we say that, okay, we are doing a waterfall agile way where we trying to do some into a sprints, but the scope and everything is fixed.
Yep. So I think in that case, the Kanban board is the best thing for us.
Yes. It's a kind of a good thing for us.
Good thing for us. Yeah.
Yes.
Scrum should be used when we have the complex project, uncertain project, when we are not knowing the what will come next or that the thing might change on the PM's review or the client's review. We have to adapt that thing to cover.
Definitely, yes, sir.
Coming sprint as well. Based on the client review, that will change, always change.
Yes.
But in that case, we have to educate our client as well because many clients do not go into that model as well.
Agree. Got it. So team, if you have any questions, please shoot. If we don't have any questions, then I'll showcase the very good projects that we already done using such kind of a sprints and such things. A very quick glimpse, how you'll get an advantage of it. And then we'll conclude this over all the Jira series. So if you have any questions, please ask.
Hello, sir. Trushal here.
Yes, sir.
सर ओनली वन सिंपल क्वेश्चन जितने भी यहाँ हमारे एम्प्लॉय यूजर है क्या वो टेस्ट अकाउंट जीरा पे फ्री में बना सकते हैं टेस्ट करने के लिए नहीं हमारे आईडी से नहीं लेकिन उनको फ्री यूसेज मिले या कुछ ऐसा है
आई डोंट थिंक है फिर भी आप पूछ लो किसी को मैं पता नहीं मुझे कि है फ्री अकाउंट जीरा फ्री नहीं मिलता सर
सर देयर इज नो jira.com
कि वो लोग क्या है कि वो टेस्ट कर पाए सर
सर उसमें क्या है एनीबॉडी इज अलाउड टू क्रिएट एन अकाउंट एंड देयर इज अ फ्री स्लॉट ऑफ सर्टेन यूसेजेस प्लस आई हैव गिवन माय अकाउंट एज वेल सो इट इज लाइक इट कैन बी शेयर्ड विद एनीबॉडी अब व्हाट हूएवर वांट्स टू यूज यू कैन बट जस्ट डोंट मेस विद द ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड प्रोजेक्ट्स दैट्स इट
आई थिंक उसके लिए सर सेपरेट हो तो ज्यादा अच्छा बिकॉज हमारा जो जो बंदे को पता नहीं है सर वो कहीं क्लिक कर देगा कोई स्प्रिंट भी खत्म हो जाएगी तो प्रॉब्लम हो जाएगी
अग्री
बेस्ट है कि थोड़ा सा अलग से टेस्टिंग वाले अकाउंट मिल जाए तो हम लोग उनको दे सकते हैं
साइन अप वो सब अवेलेबल है शायद वो कर पाएंगे
साइन अप कर पाएंगे लेकिन आपको यूज करने के लिए पेड अकाउंट होता है आपको कोई प्रोजेक्ट में डालने के लिए
नहीं मैं क्या कह रहा हूँ अभी जो आपने समझाया जो भी सीखा ना वो एटलीस्ट वो अपने खुद का कोई एक्स वाई जेड प्रोजेक्ट बनाए टेस्टिंग के लिए हमारे ब्रेन वायर में खुद के टेस्टिंग के लिए एक्स वाई जेड प्रोजेक्ट बनाए वहाँ स्प्रिंट क्रिएट करे स्प्रिंट क्रिएट करे जो भी करना है वो कर सके हमारे प्रोजेक्ट में होता है उनको बाइफरकेट मतलब प्रॉपर करना पड़े इसकी वजह से वो अपना खुद का टेस्ट अकाउंट बना ले और वहां पे दो चार बार प्रैक्टिस कर सके कि भाई ये है खुद बना रहे खुद लॉग डाल रहे और चेक कर रहे
ओके सर वी विल स्प्रेड अ वन शेयर्ड अकाउंट व्हिच विल बी शेयर्ड विद एवरीवन इन व्हिच दे कैन डू व्हाटएवर द टेस्टिंग दे वांट विश टू डू इट
या दैट्स ट्रू तो ही वो क्या है कि वो कुछ कुछ प्रैक्टिस करेंगे तो ही उनको फायदा रहेगा
ओके एवरीबॉडी विल गेट दैट सर
थैंक यू
यस गाइस एनीथिंग एल्स
No, sir.
Okay. So this is, let's say, Jira being used into one of our project called Mentis. So we have our own product into university management. So where we are following Jira in and out. So if you will see that, this is a backlog of it, in which we are maintaining versions, epics and sprints and very well. So if you look into this, we have put down all the versions because we have our own product, right? So we mentioned that, okay, when we are launching the version 1.0, 4.0, 4.1, 4.1.2. So all such kind of a versions that we have mentioned, and each of the versions, they do have the backlogs and etc. So let's say if I'm selecting all, and if you look at the epics as well, so all the modules, let's say we have a e-learning compliances, we have a DevOps, we have a some core documentations and etc. So all these epics are also being created. Now, if you look at over here, we have a sprint. So this is the current ongoing sprint that is happening. So in this, these are the tasks. This is the sprint team who are working on this. Then we can understand that, okay, how many points and everything that they're doing. So every day they need to make it out that, okay, what things they have worked so far, what things have not worked. So we already planned till three sprints, like, sorry, 167, 168, two sprints are planned. After that, we have a complete backlog. So as I mentioned, like you can plan that, okay, what you are going to do in this next 2 weeks, then what you are going to do in next another 2 weeks after that. So you can plan such kind of a sprints, and then you can keep adding a backlog to the next set of sprints, and you can create it. Now, if you go to active sprints, from here, you'll be able to understand that, okay, what are the things that is needed, like then it got converted to a Kanban board. So into whatever sprint that I'm working right now, what is the status of overall task? Is it into a still development? It is done. It is out there for QA, or what is the overall status inside it? Let me just quickly refresh the page. Okay. Till the time this screen comes up. Hello. Sorry, team, my internet got disconnected. That's why this happened. Let me quickly showcase you what I was mentioning. So here I can go and I can see the active sprints. So again, we can mention that what is a to do, what is in progress, etc. That we have covered into last steps, where we talk about that, okay, how like we can manage the progress of all the our task over there. If you are defining any of the task with that, we can integrate with our Git projects as well. So here you can define that, okay, which branch you have done a commit on this. So even though you can plan a release out that okay, I have done all these things I'm putting, you can mention out that, okay, these are the commit I have made, this is a pull request I have made, when you got the merge activities and all those things that you can do. Plus, this is the complete detailing of any of the tasks that we need to do. So this is a task, detailing of it, attachments of that, and majority of our projects does have the InVision as well. So you can also mention the link of InVision. So if there is a multiple InVision links, directly you can attach such kind of a prototype. So inside one thing, you will have all the details, description of it, designs of it, development branches, all other things. And then, as we were discussing, like it could be a priority classifications, what is a risk, what is the overall story points, which is the epic, to which component is linked, which sprint it is linked, which versions we are talking, what is the due date, and etc. So these are all the things that we define in any of the task inside it. And then we keep adding the details inside it. Overall, how it gonna helpful is they do have a multiple such kind of a reports like this. Agile reports, burnout charts, etc. So if you look into this, this is one of the burnouts and others reports are good in terms of a sprint planning. Let you do that, okay, I want to see the overall project progress. So you can see inside the time tracking report, these are all the tasks that you have, stories that you have created. What is the original estimate? How many is remaining and how much you have spent so far. So from that, you're able to understand that, okay, my task was of our 100 days. Out of that, I have already covered, let's say, 70 days out of it. And what is the accuracy? I am ahead of my time or I'm lagging in terms of a time. So all such kind of a details you're able to get from this report. And there are many such other reports available also out there. Yeah. So this is what we wanted to achieve in all the projects that we are doing. So we can provide kind of insights and assign, and like everybody knows, let's say a SWOT analysis of themselves. SWOT means strength, weakness, opportunities, and threats. So how they can know everything, that what is causing us to progress, not progress well, and we can define the things. Yes, sir. I guess that's all for my end. Anybody has any questions? Because this is the last session for Jira, and from next onwards, we'll be talking something else about other topics. Sandeep, sir, you wanted to add something?
No, sir. Not as of now. But little bit we need to understand story point and all. In detail level, I just don't know how we can calculate the strength of the resources and how we can calculate story point and define. Just got the basic idea, but we need to understand detail.
Sure. Eden, did you get a points? How to use the Jira?
Yeah, I've understood most of the points.
Okay.
I do not have any queries right now.
Got it. Okay. Vivek, sir, do you want to put out any last points?
No, sir, I'm done.
Sounds good. Okay, guys, thank you so much for joining. I hope you got some good insights. Anybody has any recommendations?
Next week's session?
Yeah. Chaitanya, you want to speak anything?
Not now, but just waiting about the access, right? So I can play around the Jira and just prepare one demo project over there. So I can learn something.
Sure, sir, you'll get that. Okay. Yes. Any recommendations for next week? What you wanted to cover? Anybody? Any recommendations?
I have one recommendation.
Yes, sir.
Some session on communication. Effective communication, smart communication, because as much as we do plan strategies, task, subtask, anything, like if we are lacking in the communication in proper way, in an effective communication way, everything will get disrupted. We would not be able to explain better in the ways. So any good session on a effective communication? So now we are going on a Jira, we are going in a proper planning way and etc. But yes, communication is also a major role in the overall achievement.
Definitely. We'll take up on that. Shweta, any recommendation from your end?
No, sir. As of now, I don't have.
Okay.
Marge, sir, one thing I want to add one more. So communication is okay, but we should add one more, like which are the things that we should take care when we are doing a demo with client, and which things we should not and which thing we should. So we understand the proper way to client and deliver the accurate our side. So it will help sometimes when we talking about with clients and we stretch our time compared to the our estimated time. So it would be a good. So we can add this point as well.
Yes, sir. Definitely. Do you have any points, any recommendations? Okay. Okay, done, guys. Thank you so much for joining. We'll again some brainstorm for something, what to do in next week, and again we'll come back with some innovative ideas. In meantime, if you have any queries about Jira, feel free to share with anyone. It's not necessary that okay, you only ping to Rizwan sir, only ping to me, or only ping to Hasya sir. You can ping to anybody. And if you find any specific things that you wanted to get highlighted in such kind of a sessions, we can also do that. So feel free to like spreading the things and keep safe. Thank you so much, guys. Have a great weekend.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, John, sir, and Vivek for the
bye-bye.
Good
session. Bye-bye.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.